J. Ray 501 here. Obama yields on smog rule. In a dramatic reversal, President Barack Hussein insane Obama on Friday scrubbed a clean air regulation that aimed to reduce health-threatening smog. Was also protesting business and congressional Republicans who complained the rule would kill jobs in America's ailing economy. Withdrawal of the proposed regulation marked the latest in a string of retreats by our lying president in the face of GOP opposition, and it drew quick criticism from liberals. Environmentalists, a key Obama constituency, accused him of caving to corporate polluters. And the American Lung Association threatened to restart the legal action it had begun against these rules proposed by President George W. Bush. N.W.O. Bush. Amazing, isn't it? The Environmental Protection Agency, whose scientific advisors favored the tighter limits, had predicted the proposed change would cost up to $90 billion a year, making it one of the most expensive environmental regulations ever imposed in the U.S. However, the Clean Air Act bars the EPA from considering the cost of complying when setting public health standards. Obama said his decision was made in part to reduce regulatory burdens and uncertainty at a time of rampant questions about the strength of the U.S. economy. Right. So, in other words, we the people don't matter. Again. How many times do we have to have this thrown in our face? And yes, it is difficult. What are we going to do about it? What can we do about it? Well, we can sit here and complain, bitch and moan. That's one thing. Very non-productive. Or, on a positive note, you can contact the White House. You can contact your congressman. You can contact, start making phone calls. Start sending out emails. That is positive action. That is positive action. Even if your voice goes unheard, it is positive action. Underscoring the economic concerns, a new report Friday that showed the economy essentially adding no jobs in August. None. Zero. Zilch. None. And then to turn around and say, well, I can't give you any jobs. There are no jobs. And on top of that, we're just going to, you know, forget about the eaters. And we really don't care about the ground level ozone. We don't care about the smog. No, the big companies need to make more money. Where was it? Down here. Sorry. However, he, the czar of the world, has successfully taken other steps to reduce air pollution, such as doubling fuel efficiency standards for cars and light trucks, and clamping down on pollution from power plants that blows downwind. Oh, okay. We've also been hit with smog control standards. We're all paying a lot more for driving a vehicle. So here we go again. And all I'm going to say is contact your local congressman, get busy. Don't give up. Don't be afraid. Step out of that self-contaminating fear. It's a plague. But that's just where they want us. It's just where they want us. Get creative. Get creative. What are you good at? What are some of your attributes? Pull from those. Sit down. Make a game plan. Go to job fairs. Not to get a job, but just to see what is popular. You can even go online and find out what the best jobs are right now. There's a whole list of them. You can go to the library. There's a lot of things that we can do. But we got to get together on it. There's also churches and all kinds of religious establishments that all have food banks now and assistance. And the reason is because as a community, I'm not touting religion, so don't jump down me for that. But one thing that I am going to say about religious entities is that as a community together, they pull together and take care of each other. And they offer that to the public as well. You don't have to be a part of a church to go there and get food or to go there and find a place to sleep for the night or have them help you find a job. It's just one resource. It's just one other resource that maybe some people hadn't thought of. Okay, so it is time to start ramping up. No jobs, and now more pollution. So as I said all along, follow the money. Follow the money. Where is the money going? Well, if we're broke, if we're scared, then we'll depend on the government. Right? Stop depending on the government and start depending on yourself, your family, and your friends. Start depending on each other to make it. Heck, I just gave somebody a bunch of clothes. I just gave somebody a bunch of furniture. Stuff that I didn't need. You know, we can help each other. It's not too late. But we certainly can't sit here and fight about it and argue about it and call each other names. All right. God bless.